Tommy looks well. It's terrifying. He's going to die. Sometime between the next few weeks and the next 15 years, Tommy will be no more. Chances are that I'll be exactly the same. Difference is we can this with Tommy. Tommy cannot get who. He can't afford to heat his gaff, put his self in a bubble, live in the warm, eat good fresh food, keep his mind stimulated with new challenges. You only live 5 or 10 or 15 years before he is crushed. Tommy will not survive winter in West Canton.
Well, I'm trying hard, Mark, but I'm not feeling anything. We were young, bad things happened. It's over.
Can we go home now?
2 hours to the next train.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Look, well, here's an act of memorial.
Nostalgia. That's why you're here. You're a tourist in your own youth. Just because you had a near-death experience and now you're feeling all fuzzy and warm.
What other moments will you be revisiting? Here's a good one. How about the time you sold Tommy his very first hit, leading him on to heroin addiction, HIV infection, and ultimately his death at the age of, what was it, 22, 23?
23.
How innocent was that?
Aye, that's mine. How's yours?
Don't know what you're talking about.
She'd be a woman by now. Maybe kids of her own. But she never got that far, did she? Never got to lead her life. Because her father, someone who should have been looking after her, protecting his own infant, was too busy filling his own veins with heroin to check that she was breathing properly. Now, how do you keep a lid on that one?